I'm searching for that special place.
Welcome back to another episode of FOOLCRAFT, my fellow friends. I hope you guys are having a fantastic day today. I'm having a great day. We're just off in the desert through the wasteland, killing a little bit of stuff. Today we're going to be finishing up some builds and some foundry stuff and some other cool things.
Got all my prep work done.
But before I get into that, I just wanted to say, guys, wow, we just hit 900 subs. I think we're at 905 right now as of recording. That is amazing. You guys have been, this series has blown up my channel in a way that I haven't seen for a long time, not since the Ark days. So guys, thank you so much for all the support and all the love and all the likes and all the comments and all the ideas. It's just been amazing. You guys, you make it so worth it. I mean, I can't say any more, but thank you from the bottom of my heart, okay? Whew, all right. So, wow, 900 subs, and we're already on our way to 1,000. I'm going to have to come up with something epic for 1,000. I wasn't thinking we were going to hit 1,000 subs until much later this year. But, yeah, wow. I mean, we're on pace to hit it in another month if we keep going this way. So, yeah, what have we done? Did a little bit more detailing work, came up with this light stand post. Very simple, very vanilla, just different textures and wood and some other lights. And bam, check this out. We created the namesake for our city here, the Death Stone. Yeah, so this is pretty cool. If you guys want to come up with some good lore for it, you know, by all means, why is this Death Stone here and why are these poor souls pinned up against it? But yeah, I did a little bit of deco craft. Got a deco craft table down below. And just laid this out. Just, you know, I felt like when I saw this and you come up here, it was this natural kind of bow in the trees and a gap, and it just felt like an appropriate place for something. We were missing something out here, and this is it. So, yeah. Anyways, I hope you guys like that. We're going to head down below, and I'm going to get a few things together, and then we will start talking about what we're going to build next. All right, so on this side, we already have a stamper set up, but I don't think we need to do any stamping. Well, we do. We have to actually stamp the Dawnstone stuff. So what we need to do first is we're going to get rid of these blocks, and these are going to get sent back into the system, which is fine. I put these down as placeholders for planning. We're going to get one of these guys. Did I grab it? I may have forgotten. Okay, we'll start with the centrifuge. Anyways, the centrifuge is something new we haven't used before, and the centrifuge is designed to, did I just forget where everything is supposed to go? No, right there. Okay. The centrifuge is designed to mix two materials together and create a new material. So pretty straightforward. We just have to kind of make these foundries, which I don't have on me. I forgot to grab them. I hope. Where did I put those? Machine accessors, activators. Oh dear, did I forget to make them? Stamper, I may have forgotten to make. Ooh, get out of the way. Get out of the way. Let's go check over here in this box. Okay, so we've got this centrifuge set up, the mixer. This is what's going to help us make Dawnstone, because Dawnstone is an alloy. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to lay down. I think we've got the melters here. So I guess if I'm trying to remember where I had this set up. I'm pretty sure it was like this. Probably not there, but whatever. We'll put it there. So we're going to put the melters down here. And so we're going to power these from this point. And then we're going to get some item gauges or some ember gauges. Probably we'll do it on either side like that. And then we can get the fluid gauge on the top. Yeah, that's fine. Like so. And then we're going to pump this stuff into here. And so we have to do a little trickery. So iron pipe. So the iron pipe is going to go into the bottom. And I hope I can do this right. Oh, I don't want that. Ah, see, that's no good. That's no good. I was worried about that happening. So maybe we can go like this. And then, of course, it's going to create a UE. Oh, what we can do is, here we go. We can come up like so, and we can go in there. Okay, so let's break that one. And let's break that one. Okay, so I got this figured out. It's all good. So we need a mechanical, sorry, am I doing iron pipe? I need a mechanical pump. That's right. And the mechanical pump is what gets the stuff out, and then we can put a lever right there. So the same thing has to happen on here, except this one's a little easier, as we just have to go around to the top like a show. Okay, so there we go. That's it. So the fluids will come into here, they'll be dropped in, and they'll be melted, and then they'll be sent around into this, and then out of here we're gonna get another fluid, which we're gonna actually, no, that's incorrect as well. We're going to pump that out using the mechanical pump, and that's gonna go into here, and then it's gonna get stamped. So it's a thing of beauty, what can I say? I don't think I have any levers on me, so let's see, hopefully I toss them in here. Levers acquired. All right, so we're gonna need a few levers. We're gonna need one on this pump, and we're gonna need one on this pump, and then we'll also need one over here to turn this on. So let's just go ahead and turn all this stuff on, like a so. Actually, let's not turn these on just yet. The other pump's on, just in case. Now, I haven't done this. I haven't even tested this, so we're gonna have to figure this out. So let's wire this up, and we're gonna get this all set up to work correctly, I hope. We're gonna run a power line over here. Oops, shoot, that was incorrect. Shift over there, and here, and shift right click, and we'll bring it all the way down to this one, and hopefully the energy flows, but I'm not too hopeful that it will until we actually have something in there. So let's go ahead and grab some copper, which I have conveniently placed in here. And we can go ahead and we can just right click in there, and hopefully the energy will scream out of there, but it doesn't look like it is at this moment. So I will fix that connection and be right back. Alrighty then, everything seems to be working. Power is running, so the next thing we're gonna need to get is some gold. And so we have to go over here. Now I replaced my config file, so my item doohickey, my remote access is not working. So let's cross our fingers and hopefully we get some gold in here, some actual gold blocks. So let's grab those. And if this is correct, if this all works the way I think it does, we should be golden here. We should be able to make some dawnstone pretty quickly. Now I know the energy's flying through the air in weird ways. We're gonna fix that all later, but let's see here. Is this, yeah, so that is actually turning into molten copper, which is great. And if we go over here and we right click on here, we should be getting some molten gold as well. And currently this is on, so we're gonna go ahead and we're going to turn this on and turn this on. And I'm hoping if I was to put a fluid gauge right here, it says molten gold there. And what does it say down here? Does it say something? It says molten gold. I'm not entirely sure what's going on here. Molten gold, yes. I hear bones, I hear bones. And here, I'm not entirely sure what's going on. Okay. Molten gold, I guess maybe it has to get to a certain amount. It says, how much copper do we have here? Come on now, why can't I see the copper? I don't think there is any copper. Yeah, see, it's draining. I don't know if we can look at it down here. Is this a thing? Oh, here we go, here we go, here we go, here we go. One copper, ugh, come on. It's kind of like a hitbox issue. I'm not sure what's going on, but anyways, looks like we can see copper there. Okay, great. I don't know. Okay, well, I have no idea if it's working. So the next thing is I can't really do anything because I can't power this just yet. So we're gonna have to go create a second power machine. So I'm gonna do that real quick. We'll set that up and then I'll be right back. All right, let's go look at Dawnstone. I think it's here. Molten Dawnstone bucket, centrifuge, molten copper. I don't know how to read that. Maybe it's copper on the top. So maybe we got this backwards. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's grab all that. Let's grab all that, all right? So we'll reverse it. We'll put the, nope, go away. We'll take the gold and we'll put this in here like so. Unfortunately, it's got copper, so I don't know if I, okay, so I, okay, you know what we do here? I know we do. Crash is nice and smart. Let's break this. Okay, we're gonna break it, boom. So that's gonna get rid of everything. We will switch up how this system works a little bit. Oh no, I got the block. The block is gone. Okay, let's try this again. I could be just, we got it backwards in terms of where stuff needs to go. Is that right? Yeah, okay. So you are not gonna go there. You are gonna go on the top, okay? Mm-hmm. Okay, and then you are gonna go on the bottom. Aha, okay. So now, let's see. Can I see what's in here? It's possible. Let's feed this. Let's see. I don't know. Maybe we get Dawnstone now? I'm hoping. Do I have to break this? I may have to break this as well. And that's going to go back into this chest over here. Let's grab the stamp base. Okay. I'm crossing my fingers. Hopefully this works. Let's see. Can I put it on there? I can. Okay, good. No, I don't want. No. Come back here. Thanks. Give it to me. Thank you. All right. So switches up. We have molten copper in here. Maybe we need to put some gold back in here. I don't think there was enough gold. Okay, gold in there. And then hopefully in one of these things, is this going to fill it up? There we go. Copper on the top. Whoa, jeez, that scared the crap out of me. Okay, and then we're going to get some gold and the gold on the bottom. And hopefully we end up with Dawnstone. We should see some Dawnstone there, and it should start stamping away. Oh, yes, of course, we can't stamp anything when this is not activated, but let's go ahead and do that. So that machine's turned on as well. So we've got everything going. We've got the gold going in. We've got gold. I don't know if we can see the gold down here. Maybe we put one on this side. I can't remember. Is it a thing? There it is. It's kind of a gold. Okay, let's check over here. I don't see anything happening over here. So let's go ahead and turn that back on. Oh, that's different. That looks different. Doesn't it? Or is that just copper? Okay, as it turns out, I was pretty close. This we don't need. I was very, 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 very close to the correct setup. I just made a boo-boo. As I made the boo-boos, and the boo-boo was pretty simple. Everything's got to go in the bottom. Everything's got to go in the bottom. So, that's a pretty easy fix, right? So we just got to do that. And then everything's going to mix in the bottom. And let's see, do we have... We do. We have a gauge there. And then all we have to do now is grab a pump out of the top and a lever and like a so. And probably... Let's see. Let's get all this stuff out of here. Mm-hmm. And then we'll break this. Uh-oh. Ow! That may have gone back into the system where I don't want it to be. Oh well, we have a few extras. So let's get rid of that copper. I may need to get some more copper. This could be a thing. So yeah, in theory, this should be the final solution for our problem. Okay, now there is some gold in here. We've got some gold in there. We don't really have any copper left. But that is probably not an issue since it's everywhere around here. Let's grab this copper real quick. It's going to go into the system, which is fine. It's actually going to end up in the hoppers if my filtering system worked kind of correctly, I hope. So let's grab that. And yeah, you can see it spitting it out there. That's good. The system is working as intended. Fan-freaking-tastic. 23 of that. So let's toss that in here. No? Hello? Did it go in there? Okay, it did go in there. And then I guess... Yeah, okay, there comes the power. Power's melting it. Then we can go ahead and we can transfer this. And we should... Okay, this is incorrect. So we probably, unfortunately, need to break that. Dang it! So close! Okay. Bam! We missed one critical component. This here is an ember. The ember chamber goes on the top. So hopefully, excuse me, my voice is a little croaky. I just had some dinner. I was hungry and I took a break. Okay, bam, bam. And then we'll just skip all the way over to here. Bam and bam. And I guess we're going to need another emitter. So then Bam. All right, and that's just on. We don't have a switch. So that should work. And that should go all the way down here and power that. So I'm hoping that melts. Oh, did you see that? Woohoo! That's it. That's the right color. Oh, baby. Did it work? I think we got it to work. Give it to me. What's this? Dawnstone plates. Yes. Oh, that's fantastic. Oh, very good. Very, very, very good. Okay, so that's it. That's the completed system. So we needed a little bit more power than I had anticipated, but nonetheless, it's working fantastic. So yeah, very good. Very good indeed. I'm a very happy person, especially now that I've got this stuff. Okay, so let me go clean some things up. Let me get this stuff in my inventory, and then we'll start laying out some tracks, and we'll start doing some automation and get all of these things fed with the ores that they need. All right, we have slept the day away, for real. It's now the next day, and it's early in the morning. And yeah, we've got everything all set up the way I want it. I've run the pipes and the conduits. We've run all the droppers and the hoppers, and everything is in line. So it kind of looks like a mine. We've got all the conveyor belts down. Took about an hour or so just to kind of get it all set up. It wasn't too bad. I'm thinking we start with gold and copper. So let's run these back. So these two lines here are gold and copper. So this one and this one. And the one below goes over there. So yeah, we just have to kind of pick one. And so what I'm thinking we'll do is we'll make this one, since we're here already, we'll go with gold here. Did I do this right? Yeah, this is gold. And this is insert. And then we're going to put an item filter in here, and we're going to whitelist gold only. And so only gold will go into that dropper. And then over here, this is the one below. So this should be insert, and then we'll put in another basic item filter, and we'll whitelist copper. And that's perfect. So only copper will go in there. Now, the next ones don't really matter as much. Let's see, what's the easiest way to get over there? I might have to pick my way through this mess here. This shouldn't be going anywhere. Oh, good. Uh-oh. No. Oh, crap. We don't want that to go in the smelter. Come back here, Cobblestone. Intercept. That's right, I forgot. Our pick isn't set up to go anywhere at the moment. Okay, bam. All right. let's see here. Let's get down, and I don't know. I don't think I can reach it. Let's use our silk touch pick because it's linked to this storage system still. Okay, get some EXP while we're at it. Whammo. Okay, so this one is set to insert as well, which is good. We'll toss in a card. This one we can smelt up silver, I guess. Doesn't really matter. I'm wondering if we can do 2-for-1 here, because the bin, I think we can have more than one going. So we'll do, we'll do lead and silver in that one. Okay. Is that a thing, right? We can do that. I think so. And then we can put that stone back there. And then on the other side, the last one we'll do iron for now, which is this guy right here. I guess we technically could do iron and copper. So we'll just do iron because I'm using the copper for the dawnstone. That's the most important part about that. All right, so now, in theory, once we link all the stuff up and then we close it all up and make it look pretty. Okay, so up here I just took the item filter I already created. So this is, will only extract, sorry, is whitelisted. Only these things will come out of here. And then we'll do another one over here that'll basically be all the stuff like, anything else that we want, like coal and things like that. That'll get sent back into our normal system, I think. Yeah, we'll probably install the refined storage item over here. All the transceivers will hide all that stuff in here. In fact, I'm going to probably go to the surface. Let's think about that for a second. If we dig away this... Okay, let's get something that can dig properly. Come on, there we go. If we get rid of this dirt like so, we go up here Yeah, that's the bottom of the stump. So what we can do here is we can go ahead and actually put a little marker, an access marker, and we'll have like a hatch. That way we can come back to it and fix things up. All right. What was I going to say? Yeah, so now we can go ahead and we can shift. Okay, let's see if I can get this. Shift. Okay, we've linked that to there. Okay, so now we can go test this out. Let's grab this copper here. Let's just do one thing at a time. We'll actually try some tin, and let's get some iron going, and some more copper, and let's see what happens here. So we should start seeing items getting put onto the conveyor belt. If everything's working, looks like it is. Uh-oh, error. I see a problem right off the bat here. Let's break this, and let's go get it. It should be in this chest up here. Perfect. We actually have that going turned the wrong way there. That's no good. We're just going to send stuff Hello? Oh, right. I think we had a problem with this last time. Okay, ready? Shift. There we go. Okay, let's try that. I didn't see the copper stuff, unfortunately. Let's see. Let's try that again. Let's grab some of this copper over here and some of this iron. Okay, ready? Blammo. And this stuff too. Blammo. And we know that the other stuff's not going through, which is great. Okay, so I should be able to see everything. Okay, there goes the copper, and there goes the iron. Oh, this looks so good. This looks so good. Look at this. And there it goes. And then it's going into there. Yeah. Yeah, perfect. And then this one, let's make sure it doesn't fall off. I think I see stuff down there. Maybe. Come on. You can do it. You can do it. Perfect. Oh, that looks so good. All right, that's fantastic. Okay, so let's test out gold now. And see, the energy's going. Stuff's cooking up. All right, let's see here. What else do we need to get? We can get lots of iron. Bam. So this stuff's gonna smelt up pretty quick. It's pretty efficient in terms of, you know, going down the pipeline. So we can go ahead and remove all this iron ore. Finally, ouchie mama. Let's see, what's this? Rose gold, some diamonds. Here's some lead here. Let's do the lead. We should go actually check that. Let's go silver and lead. Okay, let's go quickly see. Race. Race to the top. Come on, fly faster. Okay, we should see it now. Okay, where are you? Hello? Lead? Silver? No? Did it already go in? I seem to think this is not working. Unless I'm just so slow. I was so slow getting up. No, it's not working. Why aren't you working? Okay. Tin ore, lead ore. Lead ore, for some reason, maybe silver ore. Okay, let's clear this one out. Let's put that in there. There we go. Okay, so, there's different types. Okay, I guess. I don't understand exactly. Maybe we have to whitelist a couple. Okay. I might have to whitelist a couple silver and a couple. Oh, that's unfortunate. That's too bad, actually. Let's see here. Silver ore. Let's put that in there. Okay. Where's the silver going to come from? Hello, silver. Did that one already go through? It's possible that one actually went through. Or did we set silver up? I can't remember. Let's take a look here. Okay, there's iron in there. Okay, no energy. That's not, some of these things aren't hooked up. That's fine. What's in here? That's lead. Okay. And then we have gold. We don't have any gold because we don't have gold yet. That's fine. So it looks like everything's working. I got to connect up all the power stuff again. I got to kind of get our system for energy set up a little bit better. I think I need to add another one. I got to reorganize the pylons, and I'm probably going to put down a center pylon here. Now that I've got the Dawnstone being able to be manufactured, I think I'm going to go ahead and probably make some ingots. And with those ingots, I think we're going to make some of the splitters. The splitters are kind of designed to... Wow, I don't know if you guys can see. Oh, by the way, check this out. Bam! Night vision. Haha. My screen's so bright, sometimes I forget about you guys. I'm sorry. So yeah, anyways. Oh, here's some gold. I knew I had some down here. Let's go ahead and let's pick this up. And this and that. Okay. So yeah, anyways, what was I saying? I don't remember anymore. To Dawnstone. Yes. Now we can make the repeaters or the splitters, the beam splitter. Sorry, is what I'm trying to say. So pathetically, not so eloquently. Okay. Gold. Where's the gold? There's the gold. Okay. Gold's working. Woo. Okay. So that's great. So, yeah, anyways, that's fantastic. We should see, yep, there comes the energy. Everything's working. And then we should probably see another beam coming any moment now to go charge up this one. And nope, there it is. They're making Dawn stuff. Okay. So, yeah, that's going to be it for today's episode. I think I recorded the intro twice, and in one of them I said this was an extra episode here. I actually looked back, and no, this is our third episode in Deathstone. So, unfortunately, that's probably going to be it for this this build. I think we're going to have to move on in the next episode. I'm going to take some screenshots while we're here. But, yeah, make sure if you guys like this episode to bang on that like button down below, crash that subscribe button. As always, love to hear from you in the comments down below. Next episode is a travel episode. I got to figure out where we're going to go and what mod we're going to focus on. But I feel like we kind of have tapped into the Embers mod pretty good. I am coming back to this build, as with the rest of them. And we're going to come back and visit and finish this off. I have so many more plans for Deathstone. Let's turn off the night vision, make it moody. And I've got lots of plans. You guys have also commented a lot. So, anyways, that's it, folks. My name is Crash. I'm out. Ask yourself, are you a father man? Can you take me out?